we want to welcome you to New Harvest Christian Fellowship. We're so glad that you're here, and we hope that you enjoy our Christmas Eve service. God bless.
Symbolic walk right into the manger, right where Jesus is. And I want you to look down. I want you to see his little face. And I want you to see that our hope begins right there. Amen. So tonight, whatever you're carrying, give it to Jesus. Whatever struggles you got, give it to Jesus. Whatever heartbreaks you got tonight, give it to Jesus. Because tonight is Christmas. Tonight we celebrate Emmanuel. Tonight we celebrate that God is with us. We have so much to be grateful for. So tonight is for the Lord. We're here to praise God. We're here to worship God. We're here to kind of work through all the issues that we've had, but because of God, we all have hope to make it one more day. Amen? Amen. So as we begin, I want you to get to your feet. I want you to give God the biggest hand clap of praise that we've ever given him before. And let's worship God tonight like we never have before. So stand to your feet, give him a hand clap of praise, and let's worship God.
Keep our applause going as our children from the harvest come out.
So glad it's Christmas. She shall bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save the people from their sin.
In John 8:12, I am the light of the world. Again, Jesus spoke to them, saying, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life.
Jesus, slowly recognize.
on a cold winter's night that was so deep.
Thank you.
Let's give him a big hand clap of praise. Our children did a great job too. You know, we need more children that want to sing praises to the Lord. If we do, this place would be a whole lot better place. Amen? Amen. You did it. You did a great job. I'm proud of you. So, you know, we've talked so much about the reason for the season. And I want you to look at the title this morning. You're going to stay. You're going to sit. You're going to stay? You're going to sit. You want to sit? You're going to stay.
Huh? I needed them, and I also
know. Okay. All right. I don't know if y'all waiting for me to sing or something.
I got your song ready.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. I want you to think tonight about Christmas's greatest present. You know, we do talk about the reason for the season. And the reason for the season, no doubt, is Jesus Christ. But our praise team sang it tonight. We are the reason for this season. And our God has again blessed us in so many different ways. I want you to look at two verses tonight. The very first is John 3:16, and you know this. But what a great present God has given us. But it says, for God so loved the world that he gave. That he gave his only begotten son. His only son he gave to us. That whoever would believe in that son shall not perish, but have everlasting life. And there can't be a better present to unwrap under the tree this Christmas than that gift right there. Another passage comes from the book of Matthew, and it says, now all this took place. You know, we live in a world today that is very skeptical, a world that lives with unbelief. But we have God's word. And it says, now all of this took place to fulfill what was spoken by the Lord through his prophet. And it says, behold. And it's almost as if I would say to you guys today, look, look. The virgin shall be with child, and shall bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel. And that is so awesome, even if you stop right there, but it goes on. And the Lord says, I want you to understand what Emmanuel really means. It means God is now with us.
Amen.
Now, if God is with us and God gave, those are two wonderful presents. But one of the things that I want us to look at tonight is that a child waits for Christmas. And a child waits with great expectation. And a child wants to unwrap his presence. There's a desire in his life to look under the tree and see what someone has given to him. And when there is a child in the house, there is no unwrapped presence. Nothing is left unwrapped. And it's so awesome to watch a child unwrap a present, because they don't care about the hours that you spent wrapping the presents. They just commence to be tearing the paper apart, the ribbons and the bows, and the paper just flies everywhere. And there's evidence of the excitement and the expectation that lies around the presents. And then day after day, those presents are in the hands of the children. And then they are so excited about those presents, they want to show them to their family. They want to show them to their friends. And many times they even sleep with those gifts. That's the life of a child. The Bible tells us so often that we need to be like a child. We need to enter into God's presence as a child. But life has a way to push us to the side. The travesty of the adult world versus the children's world is that this Christmas, there will be many gifts that are going to be unopened under the Christmas tree. And many adults today have little belief, if no belief, in the presence that our Lord has given us. God so loved the world that he gave. Many adults live with very little expectation, and there are so many that live with very little evidence that they've ever seen the gift or even unwrapped the gifts that God has given us each Christmas. And the sad is that there is no desire to hold the gifts that are so precious to you and me, and candidly, no desire to go out and share the gifts with our family and friends. So I want to share with you about the gifts that will lie under the tree that our Savior was truly hung upon. I thought last night, and it was kind of one of the epiphanies that God has given me, but one of the greatest gifts that we have is the phrase, "In the beginning, God." You know, if you think about in the beginning, there is no greater gift than the beginning, because if you have a beginning, there won't be an ending. And we look at life today as a beginning and an ending, but if you unwrap this gift and understand that in the beginning, God is kind of like our wedding rings or a ring. There is no ending. There is no beginning. It's a constant, unconditional band that's around us, and that's the greatest gift that you guys could open this Christmas, is to understand that in the beginning, God gave. And in the beginning, it means that if there is a beginning for Christians, there will not be an ending. Give God a hand clap of praise. I think one of the most precious gifts that God has given us, that seems that it's kind of tucked away under the tree, is this gift of reconciliation. Sad to say, there are many people across America today, some even sit in churches on Christmas Eve, and they feel that they're not worthy to even be here. A lot of people will remind them of their past, and they won't let them get past the past to move to the future. And one of the greatest gifts that God has given us is the fact that life is truly not about us anymore. It's all about what Christ did for you and me. And we have been reconciled. But see, the great thing about it is God reconciled us to himself. God loves us so much that he gave us the gift of reconciliation. And he says, I don't care what you did in the past. Honestly, I don't care how you're going to fail in the future. I don't care if you were a drunk in the past. I don't care if you're an addict in the future. What I care about is that you have a relationship with me. And what I want to do is reconcile you back to me. Hallelujah. From the beginning of time, during creation, God wanted to fellowship with mankind. He created man to fellowship. And then we know the story, sin came in, man was separated from God, and from that time all the way till now, God does everything he can to bring into focus how much he loves us. And there is the greatest gift that needs to be unwrapped this Christmas, that no matter how bad you've been, no matter how good you are, it's not about you, it's about God's desire for mankind to be reconciled to him. Amen. Another gift I thought that was pretty awesome and is rarely open, and sometimes we open it and we put it back in the box and we put it under the tree, are the promises that God gave to Abraham and his descendants. You know, it's very easy for us to go, I'm a Christian. It's very easy for us to go, oh yeah, I have the promises of Abraham. But if I ask most people today, what are the promises that are in that gift? Most people couldn't tell you. You know, it was always funny when we, you know, got the toys and we put them together and, you know, we were real excited. The kids were in bed and now we're wanting to see the toys work. And then, oh, they take 14 AAA batteries and we only have two. And that's kind of as we look at these gifts of Abraham and his descendants, we know that they're there, but we don't know how to use them. Amen. So let me tell you what the gifts are that you have. If you're a born-again believer, these are yours. They're yours. You just have to unwrap the present. First of all, God promised us, and I don't have to tell you that this one hasn't been opened very much, that we'd be a great nation. This is not a great nation right now. Not because God doesn't want it to be a great nation. And this will hurt, and you're going to go, well, gosh, this is a Christmas message, and I want to understand. But we're the problem. See, God wants us to be a great nation. And if you unwrapped that present, you would understand how awesome it would be for us to be what God has called us to be, a great nation. And then he tells us that you and I will be blessed. How awesome would it be that we walk around in 2022, not downtrodden like candidly I have in 2021, but walk around in 2022 to go, which my favorite saying used to be years ago, I am blessed and highly favored. Well, you and I have to get that when someone asks us, even if, you know, the transmission goes out on your car, how you doing? I am blessed and highly favored. And that's one of the gifts God has given us. Another gift that he gave us is that he would make our name great.
Yeah.
You know, how awesome would it be as you walk around the streets in 2022 and someone says, hey, that's Mike over there. They're going to go, boy, he's a great man. He's a man that walks with God. He's a man that does everything the way God wants us to do. Oh, there's Shirley over there. Oh, she spends time with Jesus. And what, you know, would be so awesome is that when people look at us, they see Christ in us. So God wants us to be a great nation. He wants us to bless us. He wants to make us, our name great. But fourth, I thought was so awesome is that he wants to bless those who bless us. I want a driver for Christmas. I just let y'all know. God will bless you if you put on your seat. I have to say this real quick. Pam said I could have anything that I wanted as long as it would fit under the Christmas tree. She showed me the Christmas tree the other day. It's about this tall. And she said last night as we sat there and watched TV, she said, honey, I just want to let you know you won't be getting the driver this year. I said, I know, it ain't going to fit under the tree, man. You know? The other thing that is so awesome, too, is that God has given you a privilege. We know that we're ambassadors for Christ.
Amen.
We know that we're blessed and highly favored.
Amen.
We know that we are children of the Most High God.
Yes.
We know that we have been called to reign. And with all that in mind, God has given you and me this blessing that you and I can go out and bless other people. Amen. Amen. How many people do you know this Christmas that are sitting at home that have no one, and maybe you need to call? Maybe you need to go and drop chocolate chip cookies at their house. But they need to know how much they're cared for, and God has given you the privilege to go out and do that. Another gift that seems to be pushed away under the tree is a gift that God has given all of mankind, but it said that God so loved the world that he gave. Well, what did he give? He gave his son. You know, there's a reality in the midst of this for me specifically when it says God so loved the world that he gave his only son. I couldn't even fathom that kind of love. But we have a God that gave his greatest possession, and it's a present that's under the tree that so many people are not willing to open. But God gave you his Son, his only begotten Son, and that whosoever would believe in that Son, ooh, church, should not perish but have everlasting life. A gift given to us for one reason, because God loves you.
Amen.
I don't care how bad it's been, God loves you. I don't care what situation you're in, God loves you. I don't care if people said you're not worth it, God loves you. And that's a pretty awesome present to have. Another gift that I think is an unbelievable gift is that the world was able to see God through Christ. And now, since Christ lives in us, the world is able to see God through you and me. You know, it's pretty awesome when someone would give you something that they cherish so much. To go, here, this is yours. You don't deserve it, you don't earn it, but this is yours. And I read a little deal on Facebook the other day about the Christmas cactus. I never heard anything about that before. But the Christmas cactus blooms one time a year. Every Christmas. You don't have to water it, you don't really have to take care of it. But every Christmas, God speaks the words, it's time. And the cactus blossoms. And I believe every Christmas, God is talking to us to go, it's time. It's time for you to believe. It's time for you to open the most precious gift that you've ever been given. And that's the gift that I give to you, which is my only child. See, we have seen God's presence in this church service in 2021. We have seen marriages restored. We have seen people that have been held in bondage, that the chains have been broken down because of the power of God. We have seen restoration where people's lives were broken and they were mended back together. And we have seen so many people that have faced some of the biggest obstacles in their life, and God moved them out of the way. You have the privilege this year to open up that presence so that you can see the miraculous power of God.
Amen.
I think one of the largest gifts under the tree is the accomplishments of Christ on the cross. See, we've seen and heard about his earthly ministry. We've seen and heard films about him being beaten. We have heard how he took our place on the cross. We know that he died and he was carried and put in a borrowed tomb. We know that on the third day he rose again from the dead. And one of the greatest gifts that he's given us this Christmas is proof of his resurrection, because people saw him on the cross. People saw him die. People saw him go into the tomb, and nobody saw him walk back out. But people saw him later. 400 plus people saw that what was once was dead has now been risen. And one of the greatest gifts for us is that the same resurrection power that raised him from the dead is the same resurrection power that will raise you and me from the dead. So here's what I want to leave you with. Make the most out of this Christmas. I know it's been hard. It's been difficult, but make the most. See, if there's a beginning in your life, there will be no ending. And that is so awesome. And from creation to the birth until now, God has given us proof and provided evidence for his love towards you and me. And when you look under the tree, all of these belong to you. The world wants to beat us down, but I got to tell you, church, God, through his greatest Christmas present, wants to lift us up. Amen. God wants us to be a great nation. God wants to bless you. God wants to make your name great. God wants to use you as we go in 2022. He gave his son, which is the greatest gift of all. And I thought, you know, he gave twice. He gave his son at his birth. But he gave his son at his death. And those are presents that have been given to you and me. He has provided proof of his divine nature. We have seen the power of the Holy Spirit. We have seen the miraculous in this church this year. And we have seen people's lives change, no matter what horrific that they've gone through. But so many people in our church this year move from victim to victors. And we have seen, amen, give God a hand clap for prayer. And we have seen the compilation of the works for Christ, all that was accomplished. So tonight, you have an opportunity. You didn't come here tonight by happenstance. You didn't come tonight because it's like, oh, Pastor Keith and the church are having, you know. No, you came because the Holy Spirit prompted you to be here. Yeah. And I believe if the Holy Spirit prompts you to be here, he's going to meet you at your greatest need. Yeah. So here's what I want you to think. You have the opportunity to open up God's gifts. And the proof of those gifts or the ribbon is the ribbon, the bows, the paper that unwraps all of this for you and me comes from Romans 10, 9 and 10. The Bible specifically says, if you and I will confess with our mouth. Now I want you to see, if you had a gift down here and it was something you've been wanting for a long time, something that would utterly change your life forever, you would just absolutely be tearing that box apart. Well, tonight the box is Romans 10, 9 and 10. And I want us to rip it apart with excitement tonight, because again, the Bible says if, so that means you got a choice. You got a choice to unwrap it, but if you confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you're going to be saved. Because it's with your mouth you confess, but it's with your heart that you believe. And that is such an awesome gift that God has given to us.
Thank you, Lord.
So if there is not one in this room tonight that doesn't know Jesus Christ, and right now, hold that gift, unwrap the gift. And church, let's just all say it together so some aren't embarrassed. But Lord Jesus, tonight, Christmas Eve, I unwrap the greatest gift is your promises to me. I confess that you're my Lord. And I believe that God raised you from the dead. And I just want to say thank you for giving me the greatest Christmas present that I could ever have. Let's make 2022 a great year. God bless you guys. Thank you for being here today. See, they're standing because they wanted me to sing, but I'm going to sit down now.
Thank you.
bless you. Have a merry, merry, merry Christmas.
Hallelujah.
We'll see you on Sunday.
Hallelujah.